Hello YouTube's Grossama, and here we have today is the High Grade Build Divers Gundam Love Phantom. Now this is a mobile suit that is piloted by McGee, one of my favorite characters in the Build Divers series. And this mobile suit, as much as I really liked it in the series, I think it's a little bit lackluster in high grade form. Not really too much. It's just a couple of things that just makes me not like it as much as I used to when originally watching the show and kind of anticipating for the high grade release. But all in all, this kit is still an amazing kit to have on your shelf. I think the posability, just with the different gimmicks that it has and the overall range of movement, it just makes it a beautiful desktop piece. So without further ado, let's go ahead and start taking a look at the details from head to toe. So with taking a look at the head unit first, the one thing I will mention right off the bat is that it does come with three stickers, and these are all going to be for the head. So you have the camera units in the front and back, as well as the eye stickers. But I decided to go ahead and use some paint and just, you know, paint the eyes and the cameras and everything myself, and I think it came out pretty well. It's a little bit dark only because of the camera, but with, you know, basically the naked eye, I can definitely go ahead and see that green clear as day with some little reflective underneath it. But other than that, the head sculpt itself is pretty nice. I do overall like the V fin. I think it's pretty good. I like the angle that it does have, and then the little center jewel antenna part right here is actually a heart-shaped piece, which I don't really know the reason. I haven't really watched too much of the anime past, I think like episode 20 I stopped, so I don't know if there was a hidden meme behind that, but yeah, it's definitely shaped as a heart, and you know, the head overall doesn't look too bad. Next, we're taking a look at the body. This is when you really start seeing the Strike Freedom's overall base design into this kit. So this is definitely the Strike Freedom's torso overall. But you do have the center beam chest right here, center beam cannon, and overall the cockpit right up here looks really nice. I do like the little white parts right here for the vents. So yeah, really nice details overall. I don't really see too much in terms of panel lining, but you do have a little bit right here on the sides, but pretty much for the center and everything on the top, you're not really gonna have too much for panel line, but you do have the opportunity with all this blank canvas to go ahead and sculpt some panel lines right in there. And next, we're taking a look at the waist. Once again, this is going to be parts of the Strike Freedom. Also, the side skirts right here for the rail guns. Looks pretty nice overall. And then the back skirts is just going to be a very, very plain piece. So if you do want to go ahead and bring out your chisel, you can go ahead and put in some panel lines right inside there. Now for the arms are once again going to be some Strike Freedom stuff right there. But then you're going to have some more original parts on the top of the forearm, as well as the shoulders. And the shoulders, I think, look pretty damn good. I do like the black on pink right here, or purple. I think it's purple, not as much pink. But I think the color separation looks really, really good right here on the tips of the shoulders. And, you know, I would say the arms are pretty much your up-to-date types of inner frames when it comes to these joints, which is definitely going to be really good when we get to the posing. Okay, and next we're taking a look at the legs. The legs are pretty much the same as the Strike Freedom, except for there's gonna be some parts here, mainly for the feet, well actually the entire foot, but some parts right here for the knees, which are gonna be very unique to this mobile suit in particular. So these are all new parts right here, all the foot, but the leg right here, I believe, is pretty much all going to be the Strike Freedom, especially up here at the thigh and the hip part. So nothing really too unique except for these little spikes, which I think overall looks pretty cool. It definitely has either a, I think it was the Forbidden Gundam, or pretty much, you know, like Death Scythe. And yeah, the overall look of it doesn't look too bad. And I like the color separation when it comes with the black and the purple. Okay, and the last item we're taking a look at as far as details is going to be the backpack. Now, it's very obvious that the backpack is going to be based off the Strike Nor's backpack attachment. So, looks pretty good overall. The only major difference is going to be this part right here, which is very similar to the original, but it's going to have this little sight that's going to basically extend outwards and can be used as a weapon, much like the beam swords that were used on the original backpack. The other difference is like this one is more is pretty much angled backwards or upside down, for that matter. So I think it looks pretty cool, just for the fact that this kind of mobile suit as a whole represents a love and all that. So if you look at it, it looks like a heart. So that's what I just pretty much appreciate, and I don't really have any kind of issues with it being angled this way, vice, you know, the normal way. But if you want to go ahead and, you know, angle it the other way, you're definitely going to be able to do so. Now on these wing binders, there's going to be a lot of color separation. So once again, like no stickers except for on the head. So that means like all this yellow right here, all this is just 100% plastic parts and not anything that's sticker oriented. Now you can go ahead and start painting some things on here. I would recommend, you know, maybe painting some of these panels in there, paint some of this like an offset of the purple, maybe like a darker tone or a lighter tone, as well as painting maybe some of the I think these should be weapons right here, much like they are on the Strike North. So I think these are going to be Vulcans, and you can go or Torrents. And you can go ahead and paint these maybe gray or silver on the tip. I think that would come out pretty well. And overall, the details on the backpack with the one little thruster looks pretty good. I would just recommend maybe painting the inside of that perhaps silver. Okay, let's take a look at the articulation. The head is on a ball joint, so it can go up, down, basically move around all the way, move back and forth. These shoulder joints are going to be on little polycaps, so they really can't extend out or do anything. That's not really a part of the gimmick with this kit. But they have a pretty good range of mobility. Can move out that far. Swivel at the bicep. 2 points of articulation right here and right there. Ball joint at the wrist. Ball joint at the wrist. Side to side movement right there in the torso area. It is on a ball joint, so you are going to get some little ab crunch right there. Can turn side to side. Front skirts can come up that far. The side skirts right here have their own little mobility, which they can go all the way back that much and all the way forward. And the back skirts can go up that much. The hip joints can actually sway back and forth. Can move forward that much. Sideways that much. Backwards this much. Rotation at the hip. 2 parts of articulation, one right here. And then finally another one right there. Thrusters can come out of the leg like so. Ankle armor can go up and down just a little bit. Foot is going to be on a ball joint, so there's going to be 2 ball joints, one up here and one down there, so you have a wide range of movement. And the foot can point down that much. So in terms of accessories, let's talk about the hands. It does come with these open hands to go ahead and put accessories in. And also some open hands, so that way you can go ahead and definitely pull off some dynamic poses. Now this kit does come with some beam sabers right here on the side rails, but it doesn't come with beam effect parts, so you can definitely use it. I don't think it has been used in the TV show, but it's really up to you. If you have some extra beam effect parts kind of just laying around, you can definitely go ahead and utilize those. And next we're going to have these little side rail cannons, which are basically part of the Strike Freedom. So if you want to go ahead and use them, I mean, they look pretty good. I like them overall, and it kind of keeps the overall aesthetic and theme of the mobile suit. But yeah, they just go ahead and simply rotate out right there on the side, and you can, you know, have the open hands kind of like gripping it like so if you really want to. And next you're going to have this nice clear beam shield, so you go ahead and just plug it into those 2 pegs right there, and then you connect the jewel piece right in the center of the beam shield like so. And you can go ahead and, I would say, spray paint it whatever color you want. I would probably recommend just do, you know, pink, honestly, or if you want to go do a nice little blue, like a clear blue, paint that right over, and maybe put some like white right here where these like little effects are, just to kind of enhance it. But yeah, it looks pretty good overall. Now when looking at the backpack, there's going to be a lot going on with this. So the first part is going to be these little pretty much cannons right here. They have a lot of different mobility when it comes to the joints right inside here. So if you want, you can kind of like angle them however you really desire. And here they are deployed. I think this is probably going to be the best way to go ahead and deploy them. I mean, you can definitely pull off some different types of poses if you want, but I think these look pretty good. And you're going to go ahead and angle these little fins right here however you want, but I would probably just go ahead and put them like this. Makes it more of like a aerodynamic looking kind of position, but they do have their own little range of movement, whether you kind of rotating them like this or if you want to go ahead and keep them like that. Now another part of the backpack is going to be the Striker Scythes. So there's multiple things you can do with these. You can pull them down like so, and it's going to give it just a little bit of an angle like that. And you can definitely pull out the little scythe, pretty much a scythe. But you can pull out the blade right there and then pull this out as well. And you can definitely pull off some pretty dynamic poses that look way more kind of like a bird, you know, expanding its wings. And I think that looks pretty cool overall. But these can also detach very, very simply. And then you just straighten out the little handle like so. Okay, so concerning the scythes, they're probably gonna be the most difficult thing you're gonna have to pose on this kit, just because of the fact that these are, you know, circular, you know, hilts, but they're plugging into peg holes. So you can definitely let it rest and it's not gonna look too bad like this. But once you kind of like start, you know, maneuvering it in certain aspects, the hands are just not gonna be able to support unless you just apply a lot of friction or do some kind of modding, such as like putting putty or something of the sort, to ensure that it's gonna go ahead and hold. And definitely if you try and like, you know, pull them more downwards, this is just gonna fall out very, you know, simply. So I would say you're gonna have to just mess with it a little bit. It's not impossible whatsoever, but it is a little bit more of a hassle than what I believe it should have been. So Bandai really needs to go ahead and perfect these hands to be more compatible with the weapons that these kits are gonna be utilizing. I know they kind of use older parts, so these hands are from the Strike Freedom and all, but I mean, this is just kind of like unacceptable, at least to me. But hey, you're a modeler, so go ahead and try and fix it in your own way. Now the last main weapon this kit's gonna have is going to be the Beam Sickle. For whatever reason, it's not called a scythe, but it is the Beam Sickle. And this is not supposed to be purple. It's actually supposed to be gray. So you're gonna have to pull out that paint and go ahead and just spray paint it. First with primer, and then go ahead and, you know, just put some gray right over it, and it will look pretty much exactly how it should. Now plugging in the hand is simple enough, but it also pretty much has the same issue as the actual scythes, but this one has a little bit better friction, so you won't have too much issues with it. But like you can see like this, if you just release it from the already friction that you established, it's definitely not going to be able to pose that well. So you, if you want, I would just probably recommend putting some glue either around the part that you want, or put it on the inside of the hands to kind of like just tighten up the actual like spacing in between that, just so that way it has some friction to go ahead and, you know, rub on. But if you don't, I mean, you could definitely utilize two hands and it wouldn't be that bad, but I would just, you know, definitely tell you, you're gonna have to put in some extra work just to make this, if you're gonna have it in a horizontal way or anything that's gonna make that weight from the beam effect part go down, you're gonna have to put some work into the hand. Now when it's not in use, you can just go ahead and plug this right into the backpack like so, and it is gonna have little mobility so you can go ahead and rotate it however you want. Now this kit is gonna come with a lot of extra parts from the Strike Freedom. Nothing that you can really utilize except for they got a lot of parts for the head, so you may be able to recreate that. But other than that, you're not really gonna be able to make like a whole new backpack or any kind of weapons. Now in terms of height, this kit is not going to be much taller than a lot of the other like Build Fighters kits. Pretty much most of the stuff within the UC, even though this is CE, I don't really see it as being significantly taller or in that kind of like same height range. It's kind of like more close to the Zeta, as you can see right here, but it's definitely going to be towering over like the RX-78-2 and some of the other smaller mobile suits, like maybe from the Gundam Wing Saga. So what are my overall thoughts on this kit? Well, I don't think it's that bad whatsoever. It's a pretty good representation of its anime counterpart. Maybe some flaws here and there, but yeah, I think it looks really, really good. The colors are pretty great, and the overall color separation is something I really desire when it comes to my high grade models. Now, like I mentioned before, one of the major cons is going to be the ability to hold its weapons, which is not going to be that well, but when you can, it's definitely going to look, I think, pretty spectacular. So no issues really with the main beam sickle, as they like to call it, but with the scythes, you're really going to have a little bit of a headache kind of dealing with those. However, every other weapon is pretty much already going to be self-sustained, whether it be on the hips or on the backpack, so no problems with those whatsoever. So when tackling the pros once again, like I mentioned before, this thing is just going to be pretty amazing to have on your shelf. Not too many poses don't look bad. I would just say for a majority of them, you can definitely pull off some pretty awesome stuff. And like this one right here is probably my go-to. I love this pose. I don't know, I guess I'm a sucker for like rail guns and cannons that, you know, pretty much go overhead. And the little beam scythe on the side looks pretty good to boot. But yeah, overall, the pros on this kit, just, it is delicious. But that's it for me, guys. So definitely thank you for watching. More than likely, I'm gonna go ahead and detail this kit up and probably do some like, probably some little paint details here and there a little bit later on, but right now I really want to jump into some other kits I have in the backlog. So that's why this kit was not detailed with panel lining or really anything else outside of painting the head. So I definitely appreciate y'all watching this video. If y'all do have any recommendations, let me know in the comment section below. Also let me know if you can go ahead and pick this kit up or if this is going to be a pass on your end. But that's it for me, guys. Definitely thank you for watching. Please rate, comment, subscribe, and like always, I'll be seeing y'all in the next review. Bye-bye.